In this illustration, we'll discuss about the revolution of a p-meson. Here we are given that a p-meson hydrogen atom is a bound state of negatively charged pion and a proton. And we are given that a pion has a mass 273 times that of electron with the minus e charge. And it is saying if average life of a p-meson is 10 to the power minus 8 second, we are required to find the number of revolutions made by p-meson in the ground state of the atom before it decays. Here, for this p-meson or p-meson hydrogen atom, first we can calculate for hydrogen atom a revolution frequency of an electron in ground state is, here for hydrogen atom we are using Z is equals to 1 and for ground state we are using N is equals to 1. So, the frequency of revolution in first orbit we can write as V by 2 pi R, and the expressions if we substitute V we can write as 2 pi k E square by H divided by the radius of first orbit, here we can write 2 pi R we can write as h square by 4 pi square k e square m e. On simplifying the frequency in first orbit for revolution of electron we are getting is 4 pi square k square e 4 m e divided by h cube. But when we talk about a p-meson which is having a mass 273 times that of electron, which is significant compared to the proton. So, here we can write as we have discussed for p-meson, mass of electron can be changed to reduced mass. And if we change it to reduce mass, we'll analyze the whole situation with respect to the nucleus. As the reduced mass is given as mu of electron or mu of pi meson, we can write as this mass of proton multiplied by 273 times mass of electron divided by mass of proton plus 273 times mass of electron. This is m1, m2 by m1 plus m2. So, in this situation, this ME should be replaced by this mass of pion. So, we can write the revolution frequency of a pion is, this frequency we can write as 4 pi square k square E 4. This ME would be replaced by this reduced mass, which is MP multiplied by 273 times ME divided by H cube multiplied by MP plus 273 times ME. Here, I'm leaving it as an exercise for you to substitute the values of all constant and evaluate this result and verify it. The final revolution frequency of pion will get as 1.77 multiplied by 10 to the power 18 per second. So, if this is the revolution frequency, we can calculate the number of revolutions in 10 to the power minus 8 second R. This N can be given as F multiplied by the time delta T, which is 1.77 into 10 to the power 18 multiplied by 10 to power minus 8, which is 1.77 multiplied by 10 to power 10 revolutions. That will be the result of this problem.